Jenny Rivera, a vocalist and composer who rose to fame in the regional Mexican market before passing away in 2012, became one of the Latin world's most tragic stories. She was an American singer, songwriter, producer, philanthropist, speaker, and actor known as Dolores Jenny Rivera Saavedra. According to several media sources, the famous performer was well known for her unique banda and ranchera music style. Additionally, Rivera is regarded as one of the most powerful performers in establishing Mexican music worldwide. Jenny was awarded the prestigious Billboard magazine's best-selling Latin Artist of 2013 and the Top Latin Artist of 2013. Likewise, she was honored for her remarkable contribution to the traditionally male-dominated genre of banda music. In addition, she recorded 11 studio albums during her two-decade career, including Parandera, Rebeld y Atrevida, and Jenny. These two albums together reached the top of the Billboard Top Latin Albums chart. Similarly, she has 4 Latin Grammy nominations and is also a star on the Las Vegas Walk of Fame for being one of the best-selling regional Mexican artists. Dolores Jenny Rivera Saavedra was born in Long Beach, California, on July 2, 1969. Rosa Saavedra and Pedro Rivera, her mother and father, raised her and her 5 siblings in a musical atmosphere. Then, Rivera's family introduced her to the banda musical genre and Mexican music. Jenny Rivera began singing at a young age, but she recorded her first album on Father's Day in 1992, grateful to her father. Although Mexico's traditionally male-dominated music industry was tough to get through, she once admitted that a Los Angeles radio DJ threw her music CD into the trash bin in her presence. Additionally, she received perfect A's in school until she became pregnant with her first child. She became a mother at the age of 15 with Yanni Chiquis Marin Rivera, whom she supported by selling CDs at flea markets. She later transferred to a continuation school, where she graduated as class valedictorian. After, she moved on to California State University. It is here she received a bachelor's degree in business administration before working in real estate. Jenny Rivera's parents were Mexican. Her father Pedro Rivera and mother Rosa Saavedra came to the United States of America illegally by crossing the border. Her mother was pregnant during this time. Later, the couple gave birth to Jenny in Long Beach, California. Divorce is never easy, especially when there are children involved. Rosie Rivera may be an adult with a family of her own. Still, Jenny Rivera's younger sister recently expressed hope that her parents, DOA Rosa Saavedra and Don Pedro, will reunite one day. The former couple, married for over 4 decades, divorced in 2009 due to Don Pedro's alleged unfaithful ways. Could their daughter's wish for them to reconcile help them heal their relationship? Rivera grew up in a big household family. She has a brother named Lupillo, one sister named Rosie, and 3 other brothers as well. Lupillo is also a Mexican singer. Jenny married her then high school boyfriend Jose Trinidad Marin, with whom she had 3 children. She later divorced him due to emotional and physical abuse in 1992. In 1997, Rivera married for the second time. Her marriage with Juan Lopez ended in 2003. They had 2 children together. She then married Esteban Loaiza, a famous baseball player, in 2010. She filed for divorce in 2012. However, the divorce was not able to be finalized due to her death. Rivera became pregnant with her first child Chiquis when she was just 15. Chris is also a famous American singer and television personality, just like her mother. So you could see that the apple didn't fall far from the tree. In 1989, Rivera had her second child, Jacqueline, and third child, Michael, in 1991. Their father is Jose Trinidad Marin. After marrying Juan Lopez, she gave birth to daughter Jenica and son Juan Angel in 1997 and 2001, respectively. In 1985, Rivera gave birth to her first child, Yanni. Yanni is better known as Chiquis, a singer. She eventually married Jose Trinidad Marin, the baby's father, and they had two additional children, Jacqueline and Michael. As a result, she divorced her husband in 1992, citing physical and emotional abuse as reasons. When Jenny's sister Rosie, Chiquis, and Jacqueline accused Marin of molestation, he was jailed. However, Marin escaped from prison for 9 years before being found in April 2006. He was convicted of sexual assault and rape and sentenced to more than 31 years in life without the possibility of parole. After that, she met her future husband, Juan Lopez, in one local pub where she began her singing career. But Lopez was sentenced to 6 months in prison for trafficking immigrants shortly after their marriage in 1997. Her husband's dishonesty caused the couple's breakup in 2003, even though they had two children. Lopez was convicted of drug smuggling in 2007 and died in prison in 2009 from pneumonia. Additionally, Rivera and Esteban Loaiza, who married in 2010, filed for divorce shortly before her death, but it was never formalized. Rivera began her career by working as a real estate agent. She later began working for her father's label. In 1992, Rivera made a song for her father as a Father's Day gift. After that, she became a famous singer, which landed her roles in the television and film industry. Rivera was told by many in the music industry at the beginning of her career that she wouldn't make it. However, the latter was a tribute album to Selena, a Tejano artist killed in 1995. In the late 1990s, she was signed to Sony Music and Fonovisa Records in 1999. We Are Rivera and Farewell to Selena were her self-released albums. She signed herself to Capitol, the EMI's Latin division. She released her first album in 1995 named Chacalosa. The word Chacalosa is slang for party girl. She once said that she got rejected by many people at the beginning of her career. Many people said that her music wasn't good. However, you can see that she proved them wrong later on. In 1999, she signed to Fonovisa Records. She released an album called Que Me Entierren Con La Banda, which was her first commercial album. The hit song Las Malandrinas was also on that album. The song blew up, and with it, Rivera paved her road to success. Over the years, she released many albums and won many awards as well. She became an icon and owned the banda genre of music. In Mexico, you could hardly find anyone who didn't know her. She was very open about her life with her fans. She was very close to them. After her death, her fans were left devastated. Rivera later married Esteban Loaiza, a former baseball player. Additionally, the couple featured in many reality TV shows together. The shows include Jenny Rivera Presents Chiquis and Raxi, 2010, I Love Jenny, 2011, Chiquis and Control, 2012, Jenny Jeans, Divine Music, Divina Realty, Jenny Rivera Fragrance, and Divina Cosmetics. In the year 2017, Netflix released a short series that covered Jenny Rivera's biography. In addition, the singer's book Unbreakable was used as a reference for this series. The series explored her life as a mother, daughter, wife, and artist. American actress Angelica Celaya played the character of Rivera. There are 91 episodes in this series. The series also managed to get ASCAP Film and Television Music Awards for Top Television Series in 2018. The show has a rating of 7.3 on IMDb. Rivera received her first Latin Grammy nomination for Best Banda Album in 2001 for her albums DJ Tamar and Se Las Voy a Dar and Otro. She was the first performer from the United States to be nominated in the category. Homenaje a las Grandes, a tribute album to female Mexican singers, was created in 2003. Likewise, Jenny made her debut collection disc, Simplement, La Mejor, in 2004. Finally, her first record was to reach the top of the Billboard Hot 100 in the United States. Her album, Mi Vida Loca, released in 2007, debuted at No. 1 on the regional Mexican albums chart and No. 2 on the top Latin albums chart in the United States. It also received a Latin Billboard Music Award for Regional Mexican Album of the Year. Finally, Rivera won her first Lo Nuestro accolade for Regional Mexican Female Artist of the Year with the album, an award she would win every year for the remainder of her life. She also released La Diva en Vivo, a live CD featuring songs recorded with a mariachi band, in the same year in 2008. Rivera performed in Monterrey Arena, Mexico, on December 8, 2012, and left the stadium for Monterrey International Airport after finishing her show. On December 9, 2012, Rivera boarded a jet plane after attending a press conference. The aircraft took off at 3:20 p.m. and went off the radar after 15 minutes. Later, the plane was found to be crashed in Iturbide, Nuevo León. Further, the private plane lost contact with air traffic authorities and was later discovered crash. None of the other passengers and crew members survived that crash. It was devastating, and the bodies were tough to recognize. The plane crashed and lost control at high speed. At first, the authorities declared her dead, and her father later confirmed it at a press conference. However, the Mexican Director of Civil Aviation stopped investigating the incident 2 years later, claiming inconclusive evidence. After all, thousands of people have paid honor to Rivera, a late banda singer. According to BBC News, Rivera's children were among the 6,000 people who attended the service at the Gibson Amphitheater in Los Angeles. "We're not here to grieve the death," Jenny's son Michael, 21, told those who had come to pay their respects. "Instead, we've gathered to honor the lives and achievements of a singer, entertainer, diva, fighter, entrepreneur, philanthropist, and, above everything, a mother, the best mother." Besides, thousands of Rivera's admirers lined up at the end of the service to lay white roses on her bright red casket. Veronica Flores, one of her fans who traveled 8 hours from California to attend the service, stated, "I just came to say farewell to a Latina woman, La Gran Señora." The family sued the owner of the crashed jet, Starwood Management Incorporated. The family won the case and received $70 million in August 2016. Pepe Garza, a radio show host, revealed a stunning, never-before-heard audio clip of his last interview with Jenny on the anniversary of her tragic death. She expressed a deep fear of performing in Mexico due to numerous death threats. On December 9, 2012, Rivera died with 6 other passengers in a plane crash near Monterrey, Mexico, which has long been shrouded in mystery. Furthermore, new questions arose since Pepe Garza released his 35-minute YouTube video entitled, "The Interview Never Published, Jenny Rivera's Goodbye." Rivera had asked Garza to interview her urgently so that she could leave a testimonial in case something happened to her, according to Garza. She hoped the interview would never be made public, but she requested that he record an emotional farewell just in case. Although she revealed many death threats she received via email, phone calls, and message boards during the conversation. However, she described how the FBI became involved after she was threatened with being kidnapped and killed if she attended a performance in Reynosa, Tamaulipas, Mexico. Jenny was arrested in June 2008 after an accusation from the audience of facing physical and verbal abuse from her. She was hit by a beer thrown by a fan, provoking her to call him to the stage, where she assaulted him verbally and physically. Then, she was arrested after a fan called the cops, and after paying $3,000 in bail, she was released. Again, she got herself in another legal situation when she was questioned about the $52,467 she had in her handbag at the time of her detention at Mexico City's International Airport. For her release, she had to pay an $8,400 fine. Rivera Love Foundation is a non-profit organization that will support women and their children who have been victims of domestic violence and abuse in the United States and worldwide. Additionally, the Rivera family runs the Jenny Rivera Love Foundation with Jackie, Jenny's daughter. We aim to aid single mothers in regaining their footing, overcoming poverty and abuse, and improving the quality of their lives and the lives of their children. Similarly, our mission is to provide secure shelter for women and their children and supportive services such as housing, job training, and counseling to attain stability, good health, and employment. Delores Jenny Rivera, who struggled to feed her children as a teenager growing up in Long Beach, California, suffered through brutal abuse and lived in a garage with her children, founded the organization. The life of Jenny and her five children was changed forever by these early and traumatic experiences. Jenny Rivera, who grew on to become a worldwide singer, songwriter, novelist, actress, and television producer, never forgot her humble beginnings and pledged to God to help women in need. However, she founded the Jenny Rivera Love Foundation to recognize the importance she received and give back to the community. Furthermore, the foundations help single mothers maintaining their spirits despite their abuse. Above all, she remains in people's hearts for her promise to serve others, her great heart, and her favorite phrase, "It is better to give than to receive." So it's still unknown who manages her social media accounts. Social media links Instagram and Twitter. Jenny Rivera's estimated net worth at the time of her death was around $25 million. Her work in the banda, naughty, and mariachi music genres made her famous. Overall, she had 15 gold, 15 platinum, and 5 double platinum recordings during her career.